Hi class 6, welcome back to the maths class once again. So today we are going to continue from the number 3 of exercise number 4.5. Okay, so here you can see that the question number 3 has been written down. So I'm going to read it loud for you. So find the least number which when increased by 15 is exactly divisible by 15, 35 and 48. Now, it has been said that we have to find the least number. Now, we have to find the least number which when increased by 15. Now, this line is very important, okay, for understanding. Because that number, when increased, that least number, we don't know the least number, right? So, when that least number will be increased by 15, then that number will be exactly divisible by 15, 35, 48. Now for that, first what we are going to do, we are going to take or find the lowest common multiple of 15, 35 and 48. Okay, now after finding the LCM, we are going to find out the number which is exactly exactly divisible by these three numbers. Okay, so let's find them out. For that, we are going to use the division method. Okay. So here, this is going to be divisible by 5, 5 threes are 15, 5 sevens are 35 and 48 is not divisible. Now I have already said at least 2 of the numbers should be divisible by 1 digit. Now once again, 3 ones are 3, 7, 16. Okay, therefore what will be their LCM? So we are going to multiply all of them together and as a result we are going to get a number of 1680. Alright, now what is this number? This number is that number which is exactly divisible by these three numbers. Now we can understand this number has been already increased by 15. So therefore we have to subtract that extra 15 that has been increased from this number. So 1680 minus 15. Alright. So after subtracting them, what we are going to get? A number of 1665. And this is our answer. Coming to the number 5. The question is to find the least number which when divided by 24, 36, 45 and 54, it should leave a remainder of 3 in each case. Okay, so here what we have to find, first we have to find the common, least common multiple of all these 4 numbers and then we have to find the least number which when divided by all this 4 number it will leave 3 every time as a remainder. Okay, so first we are going to as usual find the LCM for all these 4 numbers. So 24, 36, 45 and 54. Now let's take the LCM between them. On doing so, we are going to start with number 3. That is 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15, 3 1s are 3, 3 8s are 24. Once again, by 2, 2 4s are 8, 2 6s are 12, 15 will be intact, 2 9s are 18. Then, by 3 once again, 4 will be intact, 3 2s are 6, 3 5s are 15, 3 3s are 9. And lastly, by 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2, 5 and 3 intact. Okay, now as a result of this, after multiplying all of these 3 numbers, so 2 into 2 into 2, because there are 3 2s and how many 3s? 1, 2, 3. So 3 into 3 into 3 into the remaining one, that is 5. So as a result of this, we are going to get a number of 1080 after multiplying. Okay, now this number is divisible by all of these four numbers, but we have to find the least number. The least number, which is divisible by 24, 36, 45, 54 to leave a remainder of 3 in each case. Okay, so eventually we are going to find the least number which is divisible by 24, 36, 45, 54 to leave a remainder of 3 in each case. And the number will be what? For finding the number, this number should be added with 3 because this is divide of 3. And for finding a remainder, we have to keep the 3 extra with the exactly divisible number. So as a result, we are going to get a number of 1083 as the answer. Coming to the number 7, where we have to find the smallest 4-digit number which is exactly divisible by 32, 36 and 48. Now, as the number should be exactly divisible by these three numbers, so first thing is we have to find the LCM of these three numbers. So LCM of 32, 36 and 48, we have to find it. So here, let's do it once again. So we are going to start with number 2. So 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 ones are 2, 2 8s are 16, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. 8s are 16, 2 9s are 18, 2 12s are 24. We are going to divide this by 2 once again. So 2 4s are 8, 9 will be intact, 2 6s are 12. Once again, I'm going to do this with 3. 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6. And the last one by 2 itself. 2 2s are 4, 3 1, 3 will be intact. And now, how many 2s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. And 2 3s are there. So, 3 into 3. Alright. So, after multiplying all this together, we are going to get a number of 288. Now, you can understand that 288, it's a number which is divisible by all these three numbers. Now we have to find the smallest 4-digit number. Now according to our rules, that how we know which is the smallest 4-digit number, we know that the smallest 4-digit number that we know equals to 1000, that is 1000. Now this number is not divisible by all these three numbers, right? So we have to find the smallest 4-digit number which is exactly divisible by all these three numbers. For that we have to follow a method. So what we are going to do, the number which we have got, that is the LCM, after we have done these three numbers, we are going to divide the ideal smallest 4-digit number by that number. Okay, so we are going to divide 1000 by 288. Now while dividing 1000 with 288, so 288, 3's are 864. Okay, now 864 when it is subtracted from 1000 is giving a remainder of 136. Alright, so here this is the remainder. Now what we are going to do, the rules is 1000, that is the ideal smallest 4-digit number, it will be added with the difference of the divisor, that is the 288 and the remainder, that is 136. So after doing that, what we are going to get? A number of 1152, and this is the number which is required, and it will be divisible ideally by this 3, all of this number, and this is the smallest 4-digit number. Okay, so let's move to the next one. Now we are going to learn about rules when the product of two numbers, or say two numbers, say A and B are two numbers. Okay, now we have found their HCF and LCM both. If we know the product of this two number, that means A and B, that means A into B. Okay, so A into B will be equal to the HCF of this two number and with it the multiplication of LCM. That means the product of two number will be equal to the product of their HCF and LCM. Okay, so this is a formula which we will use in this sum. Okay, now coming to the sum, that is sum number 12. If the product of two numbers is 4032 and their HCF is 12, find their LCM. So you can understand that this part is given, this part is given, so we have to find the LCM. Alright, so the product of two number here, product of two numbers equal to what? That is 4032. Now their HCF is 12 and their LCM we don't know. Okay, so here we are going to write down the LCM in the unknown panel. So while finding their LCM, what we have to do then? We have to divide this 4032, that means the product of two number, by its HCF, that is 12. So what will be the answer? The answer will be 336. Okay, so this is how we find this kind of sum by using this formula. This formula is very important for them. So this is it for this class, and with it the exercise number 4.5 ends. So what you have to do, you have to complete the exercise number 4.5 entirely and submit me over the mail. So let's see each other in our next video with something new. Thank you.